Yeah, it is a stale line, no doubt, but I'm going to make you hear it again because here was Joe Biden speaking on the threat of Donald Trump.
Well, we still need to save this democracy. And Trump is still a danger to the community. He's a danger to the nation.
Yeah, there we go, Kristin. You know it well. The only line they've got is that the orange man is bad. But this other point about desperately trying to save democracy, I come back to this point, and I don't think enough people have been making this point. If Joe Biden believes he's not up to another term, and if he believes that Kamala Harris is the best person to lead the United States, then the obvious thing for him to do would have been to resign from the presidency so that she would be sworn in this week, not spending her week trying to muscle up the delegates for the convention.
Right. I mean, if he's not fit to run for office, how in the world is he fit to serve? And I think a lot of people are slowly starting to come to that realization. And we, as I mentioned before, we don't know who's actually running the show here. But the Democrats, this is what they're going with. And apparently to them, democracy means lying to conceal your candidate's mental fitness, then rigging your primary by blocking alternatives. And then when you're exposed for lying, staging a coup to remove your own candidate and forcibly shuffling in someone else without input from the voters. It's all really gross and anti-democratic. And I suspect they're going to lose a lot of moderate voters because of all of this as people start to understand what's really going on here.
Yeah, I think you're dead right, because it absolutely undercuts their whole argument about being the custodians of democracy. They are playing with democracy as their own plaything, and it's a line that the House Speaker, the Louisiana Republican Mike Johnson, was on to. Have a listen.
I have suggested that the president should resign. The reason is, if everyone acknowledges that he is incapable of running a campaign, then he's clearly incapable of running the country. I mean, he has the nuclear codes. He has major decisions that he has to make every single hour of every day, and he does not have the faculties to do so now.
Yeah, House Speaker Mike Johnson there. Now, Kristin, this is a powerful point because for our audience here, just remember, of course, Joe Biden remains the president throughout the campaign under the American system. You know, he's president till January. So the whole time that Kamala Harris is out there or someone else trying to say, vote for me, Joe Biden's in charge, admitting that he's not up to another term. And the fact is he hasn't resigned. So the question that you put, the very pointed question, is going to be there right throughout the campaign. That is, who is actually running the country?
Yes, and it's actually terrifying because our enemies around the world are watching what's going on right now. And the time to do something bad and nefarious would be between now and January, because the entire world knows we are weak. Our enemies know this. They know that nobody's in charge right now. That is a terrifying prospect. So I am very scared of what's going to happen in the next few months. You know, based on what's happened in the next week, we can only guess what's coming, but it's not good. The Democrats are lying. And, you know, will President Joe Biden even make it to Election Day? I don't know the answer to that question, but it'll be fascinating to see what unfolds.
I think you're right. I think the pressure will now increase on him to resign altogether. It's going to be fascinating as ever. Thanks for joining us again, Kristin.
Thank you very much, Chris.